We need to learn the mistakes of the past in order to not repeat them.
School board member Dr. Deborah Robinson, one of the hosts of this town hall meeting, set up to update the community on the status of infusion of African and African American studies in our schools.
We're making sure that we serve the needs of our children, making sure that the history of our people is taught in our schools.
Superintendent Dr. Donald Fennoy addressed the attendees.
It's important for all of us to have moments like today where we can dig deep into who we are.
Dr. Fennoy is proud of the progress inside our schools. He believes the town hall is another step forward.
I think a short-term goal is to have an honest conversation, is to literally open up the avenues of dialogue, to put people at the table to have conversations around solutions.
One solution, implemented at Palm Beach Lakes High School, requires all freshmen to take African American history.
As a human, what would be a natural right?
Teacher Nutella Page believes the coursework instills pride into her students.
A lot of kids just don't get that positive aspect of, you know, the first thing they think of is like, well, we were slaves, you know, and they start to realize like, you know, I'm from royalty, you know, and I think it's a great program for them.
This class, one of five African and African American courses offered at just about every Palm Beach County high school.
America is very diverse. It's not just, you know, world history and things like that. You have to learn about every different aspect of America's history.
Dr. Robinson believes the Palm Beach Lakes High School program is a model for all schools.
I know that we are making progress, but it's still not enough.
The school district hopes the town hall strengthen community support and believes the ideas exchanged at the event will continue the progress for years to come. I'm Rick Blackwell for the Education Network, keeping you informed.